Here in front of me, we have a 12 volt, 100 amp hour battery that is a lithium iron phosphate with self-heating pads inside of it from a company called Litime. They also do many different types of batteries. It's not just this one. They do a low temperature cutoff version. They do a basic model. They do the mini version. And actually on the mini version, I've done a sort of first impression slash review. So in case you're interested, you can have a look at that video. But in this video, we're going to be looking and sort of reviewing and testing out this battery with various different tests. We're going to be testing out the BMS on this battery. We're going to be testing the self-heating pads inside. I believe that they're located at the bottom and the top. Personally, I'm in an off-grid environment. That's what I'll be using this battery for. I live in an off-grid cabin. So briefly, I just want to talk about the unboxing experience. I was really happy with that, basically. It's well padded. You get all the documentation inside that you will need. You get the 5-year warranty, a bunch of different stickers. You get all sorts of different documentation about managing and looking after this battery. So personally, I was very happy with the boxing experience. I thought it was really well packaged. The shipping was quite quick. I'm over in Europe, and if you're in the United States, I think it'll be quite quick as well. Also, it's important to probably mention that Litime actually offer their batteries in many different countries. It's not just in Europe. They also operate in the United States, Japan, the United Kingdom. I thought that was interesting. That's kind of a unique thing. They actually do ship and sell and operate and offer batteries in the United Kingdom. I thought that was cool. And you definitely will be looking for a battery like this if you're living over in Canada or somewhere like Norway and Sweden, because this is the self-heating model. So I tested out the BMS on this battery. It is rated up to 100 amps. There's also a surge rating on this BMS, and I will leave on screen how much that is. I wanted to find an item that I have where I was able to test the BMS to see if it actually can give off what it claims. And actually, I've been really impressed with what Litime's numbers are. That is something I would highlight with this battery. The Litime are being very honest about the numbers that you're getting out of this battery. So I did a battery capacity test over on the Mini. You can go and have a look at that video in case you're interested. I was able to get 101 amp hours out of the Mini, and I was able to get 1,305 watt hours out of the battery. I'm certain that you'll be able to get the same amount of amperage out of this battery. I think it's fantastic. Those tests are quite long to do. They take about 10 hours to complete, but it's definitely worth testing to see if your battery is actually the capacity that it's rated to. And Litime are very honest about that, so that's a really good thing to see. So in terms of the BMS, I did a test where I took my induction stove and I basically connected that up with my 2000 watt inverter. Small side note, if you do want to run a 2000 watt inverter with this battery, you're going to need two of them. I won't get into the details of that because I've already explained that, but basically 12 volt system, you have to have two batteries. If you're going to run a 24 volt system, then you can use one battery. I'll leave it at that, but there is some research to be done. If you need to know more about that, I will leave the video down below or either in the iCard where I explain in a little bit more detail as to why you'll be needing two batteries if you want to run a 2000 watt inverter. But basically with my 2000 watt inverter, I ran a 1000 watt load. I took my induction stove, I ran it up to 1200 watts, which gave me about 116 amp hours because I wanted to test it slightly over the limit just to make sure that it really could to give off 100 amps out of the BMS. I took my amp clamp meter, which is also from AliExpress. There's amazing stuff you can get from AliExpress now. You've got to really look for the stuff that you want, but you can find some really good deals on there. I'll leave some of the links down below to the amp clamp meter, so the battery capacity tester, in case anybody's interested in those things. So the BMS, I tested it up to 100 amps, and well, actually I got 118, 116, and I ran it around about there for about 7 or 8 minutes. I was planning to run it for a bit longer than that, but the water actually started to boil, so I had to kind of stop the test. But the BMS was running at 116 amps with no issues up for about just under 8 minutes, which was really, really good to see. So the BMS is capable to give the amperage that you need. Again, if you run these batteries in parallel, you'll be able to pull 200 amps out of these batteries, which is fantastic if you run them in parallel. Now, I think the most important part of this video is probably the self-heating function, which comes with these batteries. Now, from what I can see on the diagram on the website, the battery has two pads in it located on the top and the bottom of the battery. And there are a lot of nuances to why you would need a self-heating battery. Why would you want a low cutoff temperature sensor on your battery? Long story short, in my testing, I want to say that if you live in an environment that's like minus 5 degrees, minus 10 degrees Celsius, even during the day, and you're charging the battery, then that's when you might want to look at self-heating batteries. But for the majority of us, I would say anybody living south of the Netherlands or even in the south of the UK, most people, let's say, even within Texas, I think for the majority of us, especially in Australia, you're not going to really need the low temperature cutoff sensor, honestly. That's what I found in my testing, because as long as you've got your battery elevated from the floor, you've got it maybe insulated, you can use the packaging that comes with those, with these batteries, just like this one actually. And as long as you've got it raised off the ground, you're going to be fine. You don't really need to worry about the temperature. However, if you're living in a climate like maybe Canada or Norway, where you're going to get like minus 10, I'm going to set my lap. Come on. This is what happens when I film outside around where I live. There's just cats everywhere. I don't know whether I should just leave this in or not. My cat loves this battery. She highly recommends it. Do you like the battery, Lily? Do you like lithium batteries? You're just gonna sit there? In my testing, what I did, I did two tests. I basically put this battery in a freezer, my portable freezer from Vevoir. It barely fit, but I managed to get it in with the bolts off. I basically did a test where I ran it for 2 hours at the minus 20 setting. That was actually not cold enough to bring the battery's internals down to the really cold temperatures. So I did a second test and I left it all night. I left it for 12 to 13 hours in my fridge at minus, let's say, 15 to 17 degrees Celsius, which I show you on the heat gun that I've got, also from AliExpress. And in my testing, I took the battery out. I basically connected it up to my charger because I wanted to have some steady current going in. I didn't want to run this through my solar system just yet. What I found interesting was that the charger basically went up to 300 watts and it was pushing about 5 amps at the beginning and then went to all the way up to 20 amps, which is normal for the charger. It's a 20 amp charger. And then what happened is that the charger started to go down to about 10 amps. What I'm assuming is that the amperage is cut in half so that then that power is sent to the pads. That tigger, not very helpful. Lily. It's a bit like Modern Family, but the cat version. Back to the video. So essentially what I did was I took the battery out, I put it on my charger, but what happened was within about a minute or so, a little bit under that, it started to cut the amperage in half. So it cut it down to 10 amps. Once the temperature inside reaches a comfortable level, ambient temperature of the battery might get to around 5 degrees Celsius, then it allows charging again. And that happened really, really quickly on this battery. I basically had a sensor which I put underneath the battery to measure the temperature. It's the closest I could get to the pad, basically, to measure what the pad does. And I did see that I was getting 20 to 25 degrees Celsius. So the pad was heating up. And also the outside shell was going from like minus 10, minus 15, all the way up back to 0 to 5 degrees really, really quickly. So it heated up very, very fast. Then I turned on the charger again, and then it was giving the full 300 watts and charging it at 20 amps. And the battery was back up to about 8 degrees, I believe. Although if you live in a cold environment, let's say like you live in Russia or Hokkaido in Japan, or you live in like Norway, Sweden, Finland, Canada, Patagonia, those really cold places where you actually consistently get very, very cold temperatures. That's when I would recommend looking at these low temperature cutoff batteries or either the self-heating ones, which do it automatically. And basically you can just leave them on and they should be able to manage their heat better. I think that we need to see how this technology progresses over the next few years with especially the self-heating function. In my testing, the self-heating pads do work, which is great to see. And also the BMS was handling the amperage coming in and out of the battery really well. And also when I was testing out the Mini on the battery capacity test, I was really impressed with the amount of power that I was able to get out of these batteries. So if you put two of these together, you're gonna get like, what is it? 2,500 watt hours, which is just crazy. Put four of them together, you get close to 5,000 watt hours. That is a ton of power. Like, it's absolutely insane. Another thing to mention is the weight. When I weighed this battery, I got a weight rating of 10.5 kilos, which was even slightly less than what they claim on the website, which I thought was interesting. So, I mean, final conclusions, really. I think it's a fantastic battery for the money. You're really getting a lot for your money. If you want to save some money, you can get these batteries from Lithium on the Like New, which I definitely recommend having a look at in case you're interested in that. I might make a follow-up video several years later, maybe even on this battery to see how it holds up. I might do a full battery capacity test maybe a year from now. If the amp hour capacity will hold up over the next few years or year or so, then definitely stay subscribed for that. It's a really solid battery, honestly. It's just something I've found myself to be quite passionate about recently, DIY solar stuff. And I think you really get a lot of value for money. I do have a special coupon code in case you're interested where you can get 6% off. So definitely have a look at that. It's the One Good Road number 6, I believe. And definitely stay subscribed that in the future I might be able to find some other deals. And also you can subscribe yourself to the newsletter and you might be able to snag yourself a really good deal on the sales. For example, the 11/11 sale, which happens in November, which is a big deal in China. So I'm going to be testing out some charge controllers soon from a company called Batteria Power, I believe. So we're going to be testing some of those out soon. That's about it for this video. So stay subscribed, have a look at the mini battery. And that's it for now. Thanks for watching.